Hi, welcome to PATINS TV. I'm Jenna Fallbush, and today I bring you the May Featured Solution, Vision Aid Systems.
Hi, my name is Jim Fortman with Vision Aid Systems out of Greenwood, Indiana. And I've got with me Andy Leach. He's out of Dayton, Ohio, and he's the HIMSS representative. And today we're going to be showing you a couple neat new products that are kind of new to the market. The first one, I'll start with me, is right behind me, and it's called the Jordy. Some of you may have heard of the Jordy from a long time ago. This is the newest Jordy. So it's made a few improvements. It's a little smaller. It's all high definition. But this is it right here. And what it's designed for actually is to be worn. So you can actually put this on your head. And of course, if I did that, you couldn't see what I was seeing. So that's why we have it hooked into this monitor here. So what you're seeing on this monitor is what the user would see in front of their eyes here. So right now we're just looking at this piece of paper that's underneath there. So it could be a book, a magazine, a textbook, student book or something. And then the user can select the different levels of magnification as I'm doing here. You can see it's an autofocus, so it automatically focuses. It does have all the different modes. So if the student can see white on black better or green on black, it has all these different combinations. But the nice thing about this is when I do have it off, like this, then it can look in the distance as well. There's color, so I can see across the room. So I'm a little shaky with that, but if it was on your head, you're much more stable. But then a student could see the blackboard or see the professor or the teacher, and then take it off and put it onto this docking station and then use it like this. So see, I can put my hand underneath there and write with it. Or we've had people who do crafts or paintings, art classes. I have a couple electrical engineer students who use this, and they can put their circuit boards down there and see them. It's also great, you know, everybody has an iPad or a smartphone now, so you can also put that underneath there and see the image comes up here, and then the user can make it whatever size they need to make it. And that is called the Jordy with the docking station, what you're seeing right there. Well, I'm going to pass it over to Andy.
Hello, everyone. It's good to be here. What we're going to look at today is a product that we have that actually was released at the end of June of 2017. This is the HIMSS Braille Sense Polaris. It is a 32-cell Braille and speech Android Lollipop-based note taker. So it's got 32 cells of Braille, along with speech. It has stereo speakers in it. It has a 13 megapixel camera on the back. So if you're interested in OCR, for example, you can use the camera to scan and read documents that you'd like to have access to. It is an upgradable platform. So as Android continues to advance, so does the device. I've got it here out of the case so you can actually see how thin it is. It weighs 1.6 pounds. Too many features to get into in the short time that we have here today. Right now, are running it from HDMI to a monitor. I apologize that a couple of the letters got cut off, but we had a little bit of technical difficulty. So what you're looking at right now is the main menu. It has everything from the top, file manager, word processor, email client, media. So far, everything that we've looked at are standard things that you would be used to seeing on a note taker. Play Store. Now, here's where we cross over from what you would expect out of a traditional note taker to what makes this device so appealing. We have the Play Store here, which is Google's version of the Apple Store, so you can go in and download hundreds of apps that would be useful to you. So you're not restricted to just things that were designed to go into the note taker. This device is accessible with Google Classroom for any of you educators or students or parents that are involved in a school system that relies on Google Classroom. We do have access and it does work very well.
Contacts.
Then we're gonna just go through some of the standard things. We do have docs, sheets, and slides. I can move from various slides and then use my Braille display to read the text if I don't want to to have the text of the slides verbalized.
What's what in the Polaris?
So you see moving.
What's what?
I'm moving forward. Now I'm going to reverse.
What's what in the Polaris? Overview.
So that's that. We also have Nimit and UEB Map.
Word processor.
It is in beta right now, but graphics is very soon to be released. I also want to point out that starting in less than a month, we're going to start shipping this Braille Sense Polaris Mini, and it will have all the same firmware, but it will only have 20 cells of Braille instead of 32, and as you can see, it has a much smaller footprint. The best thing you could do if you live here in Indiana would be to get a hold of Jim and let him know that you're interested in our products.
And if you'd like some more information, you can get all the things that Andy talked about on visionaidsystems.com. It has our 800 number and all of our email information. Thank you very much for having us.
Find us by searching Patents Project on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube, or on the web at patentsproject.org.